y'all. Only thing I can tell you, I come from Harlem. Carver Projects, that's where I'm at right now. My name is Eddie Cruz. I'm AKA D. Capone. I'm 41 years old. Been living here my whole life. And they were basically put here for me to sleep on when I got kicked out of my house. Well, not these. These are new. So heavy. These are steel. The benches I was sleeping on were wooden. The ones we used to tag on and stuff. They used to be green. They used to be red. You know what I mean? They used to have paint. They used to have not have paint. Splinters in your ass and all kind of shit like that. But yeah. That's how it was. Back then, when I was born, growing up over here, if you wasn't from over here, you wasn't sitting on those benches. It didn't matter who you were. It just wasn't done. Because you would make a person feel really uncomfortable in their own environment. You know what I'm saying? If you're not from this place, where all these people sit here, everybody basically knows each other. That's why everybody's always in everybody else's business, thanks to these benches. Sit here and just be like talk. Nothing better to do. Or sometimes they come out and have good times, talk, get drunk, and then there'll be a fight. Or a barbecue. These benches symbolize to me, you know, it also symbolizes when you ain't got nowhere to go. Or you don't want to go nowhere. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, these benches is what cause a lot of conflict. Because people just sit here and they talk about everybody else's problems. Yeah, I mean, there's a good side and a bad side to the benches. You know what I'm saying? The good side of the benches is, you know, it brings your community together, the people you live around. You know, you don't wanna be at war with the people you live around, even though sometimes that happens, but that's got nothing to do with the benches. That got to do with alcohol and drugs. You know what I'm saying? Benches are also here for, as far as I'm concerned, as far to scrutiny. You know what I mean? So people can actually scrutinize where we at. They know where we at. They know what we're doing. We're in a little community. You know what I'm saying? And as long as the police know that they could come into one little circle and find everybody in one little circle, it makes it easier for them to deal with. If you give people like us so much space in the projects and around and stuff like that, then they don't know who's doing what and where people at. You know, it's all about keeping things stable for themselves. It's like if you go on the Florida right now, a lot of people got nice houses and stuff, but they still will find a nice little project place where they make for a certain community of people, which would be blacks and Latinos, you know what I'm saying? As far as I'm concerned. Yeah, I still take pride in my neighborhood. And the bench is that's like, in a little way, your sanctuary. That's just your, how can I say, your solitary confinement, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's your spot, that's where you feel comfortable at, you know what I mean? You don't like nobody invading your space. I mean, the bench used to be over there by the park. I witnessed two kids get shot up by two other kids that I knew. That's because these dudes were sitting on the benches and they was from Brooklyn. They wasn't even from Harlem, from our projects. And that's the reason they got shot. For sitting on a block thinking that they was really cool and they came from another borough. Yeah. The niggas was like, what the fuck you doing over here? You don't know where you at? Let them have it. Then the funny thing is, after they got shot, they ran in this building. I go in the building, and I'm in the elevator with them. But I ain't shooting them, so I know they didn't got no problem with me. I know you hear them saying, yo, I'm hit, son. I'm shot. I'm hit. I'm coming back. You should just go home to the hospital and stay there. Because you're going to find that in every project. Every project. Only projects that got benches right now that I can say is really secure is Franklin Plaza. Because they got like a police station there and there's always security guards out there that are like police. there's nothing you can really do over there and think you're gonna get away with it. There's too many cameras, too many police. You know that from these benches, you sit here, you can see your kids, you can see what they're doing, you can see everything around you. Now, I wouldn't want to see them on the bench. I'd rather see them in the park. The bench is only there for them if they get tired of running around. But when they kids, when the kids get tired, I would never want my kid to get tired and just think it's always about the bench. And the only reason I'd be scared to bring my kid around the bench is in the projects, because it depends on where you at. Over here, I wouldn't have no problem with my kids being anywhere around here, because I've already made my stand here. I don't really care.
Look at Marvin, man. They're coming over here doing their film for Carver. You know what I mean?
Right.
TFL, tough football league.
Order!
All right. Let's beat it up.
Yo, Black!
What up? This is what happened with the benches too, man. Bring the community together, as you saw. You know, everybody be sitting here in one group, and they'll come up. It's like a stomping ground too, like a meeting ground. Like everybody meets up here, and then they disperse, split up, and go other places. Right there, you know, OG Pams. He the coach of the TFL, you know, football league. Touch football league. He's doing his thing there. The quarterback for that league is my brother Chuck Martinez. He's another brother that knows what these benches are about. I was with him. We was locked up in the juvie. And he did, if I'm not mistaken, he did 15 years for murder. He was only 16 when he went in. No, he wasn't. He was 15 years old when he shot somebody under the influence of somebody else encouraging him. And he's been locked up on more than one occasion. I've been in there with him. We pretty much grew up in prison. And I actually say that I'm proud of him, because he was actually one of my neighborhood bullies. He used to bully me until we went to, you know, Spofford, Juvie, and he helped make a man out of me in there, you know what I mean? Now we just got the utmost respect for each other. He's doing something positive for the hood, you know what I mean? Keeping a lot of people out of jail. So far, I think we're on number 44 or 45 championships. They just won. They just came back from DR. The whole crew, like the whole team with their wives and everything, in Dominican Republic. And then every year they go to Puerto Rico. And then they go to Florida every year. They take bus trips. You know, like this guy right here, Pamby, he does amazing things, but he doesn't do it by himself. It takes a team to do things, and him and his team are doing it together. And I respect that. In a way, I kind of envy him a little bit, because I wish I wouldn't have did as much time as I did, and I could have been out here doing the same thing they were doing, playing the sport that I love, football. You know, going places and doing things. I don't do that no more. That's another thing about these benches. They can sometimes help you and sometimes drag you down. I mean, the only one that can keep yourself stuck in the hood is pretty much yourself, you know what I mean? But it could play a part given the amount of people around you, because it's the people around you and your surroundings that keep you down, unless you're doing it yourself. If you ain't got the right people, the positive people around you, you ain't gonna get up and do nothing. All right, brother, you ain't gonna get up and do nothing positive, period. You're gonna sit right here on the bench and be comfortable sitting there. While everybody else is driving and moving places and going places, you'll be right here on the bench.
So the cameras give you a sense of security?
Yeah, it give me a little sense of security. Well, if they're working, because some of them don't work. It'll give me a little sense of security, you know what I mean? Because that's what the, you know, law enforcement.
So now, when your sons get older and they're teenagers, and you catch him hanging out?
No, if I catch him on a project, but 9 out of 10, he got something in his pocket that he's selling, and I'm whipping his ass.
So you wouldn't want your kids to hang out on the benches when they get older?
Not when they get older. When you get older, the benches was there for you when you were young and got tired and you needed to rest. The bench is not there for you to be sitting up there when you're already 17 years old, 16 years old, and should already have a job. What are you doing on the bench? You should be working. You should be doing something positive. You should be doing the opposite of what I did. That's the purpose of me being there for you. See, the difference is I didn't have nobody there for me. My kids do. Big difference.
So now, for the people that believe or feel that they have some ownership or some claim on these benches, do you feel that they have a valid, you know, belief, or that they're really deceived? Because
for anybody who thinks that they're claiming a piece of property that belongs to the state and government, you've got to be the dumbest person in the world. I mean, there's no claiming nothing that the state built. Nah, it's something that you bought it. It's mine. You know what I mean? Everybody makes false claims, but the only thing you basically really claiming is your so-called territory. And the bench ain't one of them.
I think that's pretty good, my brother. I want to thank you. And if you have any closing things that you would like to say.
Yeah, I got a song that I'm going to bring to the table that I did with a friend of mine, Will Starr.
All right, bro.
Will Starr, it's called Project Bench. And I think you'll understand what it, you know, it's, he basically, what he does is, he puts himself as being the bench. And this time, by him putting himself as being the bench, it's actually a story that the bench is telling, not him. You know what I mean? I think you should look for that soon. As soon as I get it, I will be putting that with this episode, and hopefully it'll give you a little bit more insight on what these benches could do. Pretty much.
It's a sense of security, so you're to be comfortable. Cool, and it's this conference where you are trapped in a box. You don't want to look outside the box because they want to make it tough.
They sit in front of the bench and dope, you're not motivated to do nothing. You know what I mean? You're just sitting here. This is what we do all day. We,
from the time you wake up to the time you're on the bench, you're here. That's what we do. You know what I mean? And they want you to be stagnated so you don't think, like, we can't.
I mean, if it wasn't the building, it was always the bench, right? It was the benches that got us.
Times coming outside and these bitches
some
be pulled up.
Yo, some people got their first piece of pussy on the bench.
Yeah.
Some people got used to get their first piece of ass on a bench.
What?
That's when they used to tag their name, like, I just booed this chick
on the bench. On the bench.
Behind the bench. Oh, and where we used to put the stash at? Behind the bench. Where the stash at?
We have bitches right here. You know what I mean? We sit right here and come out. We have bitches right here, long stuff. This side, this wasn't here. We had the grass, but it wasn't all this grass.
Easy access for police?
Police to get in, what's the thing? You know what I mean? They can get in, they can come, they can control the area, and it's easy for them to see what's going on. You know what I mean? Except for us to come out here and be peaceful and sit down where we live in our community and be at peace. We gotta be uncomfortable, because they wanna come, you know, have easy access to get, you know, whatever they wanna do. You know what I mean? Stigma, we wanna keep, once you relax. We don't want you to think about nothing outside the home. We want you to find to the project.
Besides him flipping off of them?
Flipping off the benches, seeing people get beat underneath the benches. A lot of things in this world happen near the, which is funny, it's a funny topic. You're speaking on benches, but a lot of things happen in them benches, right?
Yep.
I started getting money fucking with them benches. Watching the older brothers get money on them benches. You know?
So do you think people from the community take a sense of ownership to their benches?
Yes. Yes.
So if they see a stranger on the bench, you think it'll be an issue?
Yes, of course it's an issue. Because we don't know you, you're just sitting here, you're lounging. What are you here for? Who are you here to see? Like, we need to know these type of things, because right now in our community, time and days and age, people are crazy. They snap you in a second. So with that in mind, you have to be aware.
And you got babies running out here. We gotta protect our babies. Yeah, so, four sensor on it. As you see, the bitch is not here. So, obviously, they not here. So, that answers your question right there. You know
so, at any given time, they can just move the bitches.
So, we might, like you said, a four sensor security say, yeah, they got bitches. But once they up and move them, our bitches where? They all gone now. So, now we all standing.
Yep. So, now, do you think in richer communities, do they have benches in front of their buildings? Yes or no?
Well, it depends. Well, I've seen.
If you go down Park Avenue, Madison Avenue, they got benches in front of those.
No. We don't have benches. Never. You know, I never see a bench in front of Park Avenue or nothing like that.
Might see a swing out there.
You know, anything. Word. Fuck with them. You know what I mean? But it won't be no benches there. They get money. They got benches for.
Because they don't want people to be loitering and hanging out
in front of them. On the area where they live.
But it's a difference in our community.
Let me ask you a question. How many times you came across me and see me sleeping?
A lot of times. 2-3 in the morning, my man out here on the bench. Not just him, me, my
man. Man, bags of crap in my pocket.
Vaya, Oricua, Dios la bendiga. Vaya.
Hey, mommy.
Hey,
I know, mommy. How you doing?
What happened to you?
I was in a car accident, mommy.
Like I said, man, the bench has got its good qualities and it also got its bad qualities. Bench sitting on a bench all day can make you really lazy. You know what I mean? And then you start seeing people choose out. Like, you this day, kid, serious? We live here. This is where we live at. This is what housing, you know, Democrats, no disrespect to them, because they do fight for, but this is what they fight for. For us to live like this. You know what I'm saying? So Democrats fight to give us something good, and the fucking Republicans will fight to still get some type of control and fuck it up. Look at where we at. You telling me we can clean this up? We wouldn't be better? This shit is trash. Look at this shit. Benches. It's only a matter of time before everybody leaves this big and be sleeping on the benches. That's gonna be their house. I did it. I slept on a bench. I passed out on the bench. I got drunk. Didn't even remember until I woke up on the bench.
You can please just let the people know your name.
Jeremy Hazell.
And where we at right now, where you from?
You already know, Carver Projects 104, Park and Madison, Eastside all day.
If you could give the people like a little, you know, rundown for those that don't know who you are.
Hey, if you don't know who I am, nigga, you ain't from Harlem, man. It's the cab driver, a.k.a. Jeremy Hazell, nigga, best ball on the east side, nigga, all day.
All right, that's what it is. So, if you can let the people know currently where you at, you know?
Shit, playing in France this year, just got back home. Shit, you already know how that is, balling overseas, doing my thing. Regular shit, though.
All right, that's what it is. So now, this show that we're doing is a series, it's called Benches. So now, the benches that you sit on right now, basically, what do you feel about the benches and the project? Why do you think that they were put here?
Man, for us, nigga, the block niggas, they hang out, chill, barbecue, drink, smoke, do whatever. Just have a good time, just chilling your projects. Shit, regular shit.
So do you think that it was set to keep people in the projects? Or was it just for more of a social thing? Or was it kind of set to keep people, you know what I mean? Like, to hang out in their hood and not really explore outside of their hood.
For me, my thing, I just think it's for like the old people, or just people just want to come down, chill in front of their buildings, just relax in the summertime, just hang out with their friends and stuff like that. So that's why I think they got the benches here. But we use the benches for different things, man. The hood niggas, you know how that is.
So What kind of things would you say hood niggas use the benches for?
Shit, man, all types of illegal shit. I ain't gonna put it on the camera though, but y'all niggas know what I mean, though.
Uh-huh. So now, growing up, have you ever seen, you know, any type of situation pop off at the benches or like altercations?
There's too many shits on the benches. To be true with you, man, I got shot on the benches, man, by the benches a couple years ago and shit. So, man, everything happened in the benches in the projects. Anything could go down.
So now, at this time, when you had got shot, can you give a little rundown of like where you at was at? Was you already, you know, in college, playing ball?
Yeah, that's a fact. I was definitely in college. It was like my senior year, Christmas and shit. I was back in the hood and shit, and in front of my baby and shit. And, you know, a little situation I got handled and shit like that, but I'm all good, I'm here.
Yeah, definitely, thank God. But so basically, hanging on the benches could have affected your future and quite possibly your life.
That's a fact, it did. It affected my future a little bit, but you know, I stuck with it and kept it going. Now my future bright and I'm doing what I'm doing.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. So now, do you feel that certain people are take pride in, you know, obviously everybody takes pride in their hood. So now, do you think people could be territorial over benches if they see like a stranger that's not from their hood?
Oh, that's a fact. That's a fact. I don't like nobody walking around. Sitting on our bench. I know it's a miscellaneous face you ain't never see sitting on your bench. You go, actually, yo, who this nigga right here? And you probably step to him like, yo, what's up? You live here? You know how that goes, hood niggas. Oh, don't want nobody in their project, so that's always rule number one.
Exactly. So now, basically, you know, so you would say that that people feel like they own the benches then?
Oh hell yeah! You from the, if this is your projects, like this is my projects. I live here. This is our benches. If you live in the projects, your benches. Like you're not from this project, it's not your benches. Don't sit on it. This is our shit. Get out of here. Like, go ahead. Go to your shit.
So now, do you feel that the benches is a place that people can like spread rumors and gossip?
Oh, that's definitely this right here. This is the gossip like fucking mansion right here. You see, we got my niggas over here. They chilling, just talking about regular shit. And then when you got the old people over here, they talk about what they be going through in their days and they shit. So it's a trickle down from the young kids to the old ladies and all that. But we all talk about different things. We talk about the hood shit. The little kids talk about what they doing. Older people talk about what they doing. So the bench is definitely a gossip place, man. You can come here and hear some shit, some real shit on the benches. Word.
Definitely, definitely. So yeah, you know, I appreciate it. I don't want to take up too much of your time. You know what I mean? And definitely, you know, it was a beautiful thing to have you, right, you know what I mean?
No, man. All right. Cad, all day, Eastside.
Thank you, my brother. No, good looking to you, yo.
You know.
All right, what's up, y'all? This is Chuck. This is Carver. 106 99th Street.
Did you spend a lot of time sitting on the benches, or would you say you spent more time being active?
I would say it was a half-half. Of course, a lot of it was, you know, in the park, playing, stuff like that. But then, you know, when it was chill time, benches is where we was at. Chill either in front of the 106 or even in Black Park, chilling on the benches and shit talking, you know, chilling and shit.
If people that didn't belong in Black Park, quote-unquote, like, how would they be received hanging out in Black Park?
Well, what happened is the guys from Black Park will walk up, you know, about three or four of them walk up and be like, excuse me, you know, who y'all, where y'all from, whatever, y'all can't be here, I gotta go. And, you know, if they didn't get up and leave, whatever, then it was a problem. And trust me, at that time, ain't nobody want no problem. Well, from growing up, my moms, you know, all the older people used to come outside. They find some shade, sit on the bench. A lot of them had their little cooler and stuff. They used to get like beers and stuff like that. Play their little music and stuff and hang out, whatever. Then on the other side, you see the fellas and stuff chilling, you know, drinking their little beers or smoking or something like that. Chilling on the benches, whatever. So that. The benches was a big part of growing up because it gave us somewhere to chill, relax, you know what I'm saying, and build the friendships that we built from being young.
So on a positive side of the benches, what would you say is a positive aspect to the benches?
It kept a lot of people, honestly, it kept a lot of people out of trouble. I mean, if you come outside, there was really nothing to do, whatever, you found some shade or something in the summer, you sat down, whatever, chill on the benches, whatever. A lot of times, start playing cards, start playing dominoes on the benches, whatever. The benches wasn't there, people come outside, now what we gonna do? All right, there's nowhere to sit, nowhere to chill, now we gotta walk around something or find something to get into. And then, you know, being young, whatever, that's when, you know, the kids get in trouble.
So now on the flip side of that, what would you say is there a negative side to the benches?
I would say probably the only negative side would be, like, you know, when they were selling drugs and they was using the benches, like, you know, for people to sit down and make sales, it's like that, whatever. And it kind of made people lazy. You know what I'm saying? The benches is there, whatever. Nah, I'm not gonna walk around or do something, whatever. I'm gonna just come outside, sit on the bench, and then just relax. So it wasn't really too much negative, but, you know, it was a little bit negative.
So in that sense, do you think that the benches can act as something to, like, hold people and not explore?
Right, exactly. Like, you come outside, you sit on the bench, and you feel a little lazy, whatever. Now you're just gonna relax and stay there. Now if they're not there and you come outside, now you're gonna walk around, you're gonna try to find something to do. You know what I'm saying? So you could, stay active and stuff like that. So you're either gonna walk around, they playing ball, you might just wanna shoot around, you see somebody playing catch, you just gonna walk in just to do it because there's nowhere to sit, nothing else to do.
So do you feel that hanging on the benches could be dangerous sometimes?
Back in the days, I say no, but nowadays it could be, only because, you know, police walking around, stuff like that, whatever, depending on where you live at, what area, for some reason, the cops will think, you know, you're doing something wrong, or, you know, if it's too many of y'all sitting down, they think some activity or something's going on, whatever. So, in a way, that could, to me, that's the only dangerous part of it.
Well, I had interviewed Jeremy Hazell, and he was talking about how he was sitting on the benches and he had got shot. And he came to visit from, you know, he's playing ball for school. So, you know, do you know of situations like that, besides that one situation, are like innocent people just getting caught up and stuff?
Well, I'm not sure about shooting and stuff like that, but before Herb, we was all sitting on the benches, and Herb from 106, somebody threw like a half a brick or something like that off the roof, and it hit him like in the knee, whatever, he had to get surgery and stuff like that. So, you know, when people do stupid stuff, like the benches and stuff like that, whatever, it's like you're a target. Easy, you're just sitting there, whatever, and then, you know, they can throw stuff, hit you with stuff, whatever, so that. So that part is definitely dangerous also.
So now, this is pretty much the final question. Do you think people from certain neighborhoods or people from the neighborhood could be territorial over their benches? It ties into the other question, but even nowadays, like if people come and they see people hanging on the benches that they don't recognize, For example, when I came here with camera, they're like, yo, the lady I was here, she was like, you know, what you filming? What is this for? And like, she inquired, you know what I'm saying? Do you think, like, people have a sense of, like, you know, defending their neighborhood or like a pride? Of course, there's a pride in where you come from and everything, but like a territorial or like security aspect of it. Do you think that takes place?
Yeah, I think more is not necessarily the benches, but when they come out and you're chilling and you see people you don't know, even though they're sitting on the benches, it's not really about the benches. It's kind of like, who are they? What are they doing here? And then it comes like, you know, the protection part of it, like are they here to cause harm to somebody or, you know, for beef or something like that, whatever. So they'll get asked the questions, but it's mainly for protection as far as hope nothing is happening or going on while we're going to be here chilling. But the bench part, you know, first come, first serve. Whoever makes it to the bench first, you know, gets to chill, whatever. But as soon as you move, you lose.
I just want to say on camera also that, you know, when I was growing up, I used to see you playing basketball, and you were such a phenomenal athlete, and still to this day, you're such a phenomenal athlete. I remember seeing ball games in Carver, and you just hitting three-pointers, like, forget about it, you know what I'm saying? Like left and right. So, you know, I just want to, you know, touch on that real quick and just say that I'm honored that you're a part of this, you know what I'm saying? That you took time to be a part of this. As far as a message to the youth, should they spend a lot of time hanging on the bench?
Well, thank you. Appreciate all that. Growing up in the projects with the benches and everything, it was a big part of our life, just like that. But like I said, playing sports, doing stuff with, you know, your friends and stuff, that was a big part of growing up. That helped me, like, become the player I am, whatever, because then the competitors came in. You know, I wanted to be, like, the best in the projects at everything, so it kind of pushed me. But then, you know, the nighttime came, and, you know, we was out there chilling with our friends on the benches and relaxing, like that, whatever, just trying not to get in trouble. That's what it's all about. You know, have fun, have your childhood, but think smart. Everybody got a future unless you mess it up early.
The benches and the projects that keep people from exploring outside of their community. How do you feel about that?
Wow. Yeah, press pause. He said another question on the question that you asked. Oh, no, that's a real hard question, man. I think it can go either way, man. I think, they probably did do that for us to just stay put and be here and not go outside the lines, you know what I mean? But they gate us in, you know what I mean? There's no reason for the gates to me, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. That's a tough question.
Mm-hmm.
I would like anybody to try to answer that question.
Do you think that people take, you know, obviously people take pride in their communities. Do you think that there's people that take a certain ownership to these benches? And if they see strangers sitting on their benches, will they have a problem with it?
Oh, of course. We'll definitely peep somebody that's like, who that? You know what I mean? You don't belong here. We know who belong here. And, you know what I mean? So we'll definitely, you know what I'm saying? Making sure you got some niggas that might even just be folks that are like, yo, you know what I'm saying? What you doing here? Shit like that. You know what I mean? Like, we don't know you, man. We don't know you, fam. So you got to bounce up out of here. Like that, yeah, definitely. I'm not gonna go sit in another nigga project just to sit there, because niggas might do the same shit.
There's individuals out here that they spend the majority of their life on the benches.
Oh, hell yeah.
And don't go leave outside.
Hell yeah. That's some niggas, you know, that's from 12 years old, we what, 40, them niggas are still doing the same shit. Yeah, hell yeah. They just don't want to do anything with themselves. They feel like this is what their life is, but you gotta think outside the box and try to motivate yourself to do better things, man, for your kids and shit like that. So you just can't stay stuck here like that. And that's what that is, but yeah, definitely, niggas stay here. You see the same motherfuckers all the time, definitely.
So now what kind of things go on in the benches in the projects?
Nah, niggas drinking. Niggas smoking weed, niggas gambling, you know what I mean, playing cards, chilling, you know what I mean? Like you said, from the beginning, they make you want to stay here. And That's the type of shit. Besides that, you, some niggas asleep on the bench. That's the only outlet. Nah, I'm not talking about you. I didn't see that. That wasn't me.
I was the father and the sister that came and got me from sleeping in bed.
Yeah, it wasn't me. I just heard about it. I heard about it.
It's my cousin. Blood cousin.
Blood cousin. That's a little bit of Heineken talk. You know
what I mean? They got more in there?
So now, you have children, right? Now, if your kids, when they become teenagers, you see them hanging out on the benches, how you gonna feel about that?
Not good, because it's not leading anywhere. You know what I mean? That's why I lived here. I lived in 60 East 106 for a long time. I live in the Bronx. Not like I live in the Bronx now. I live in a house, you know what I mean, with my wife. Bought a house, you know what I mean? You just have to try and better yourself, man. You just can't stay here, man. Whatever you want to do, you just do. You know what I mean? And that's all I can say about that. Same shit's going to happen all the time. You just come outside on the weekend, drink, chill. You can do that shit anytime.
Do you think you could learn from hanging out on the benches?
Nah.
You can't form an education from hanging out on the benches?
Ain't nothing to learn here but drugs and gambling and
so learn shit. Learn the street life, basically.
All street life, you're just going to chill out here. That's how it is, man.
And obviously, you don't want that for your family, for your kids, right?
I want better for my kids. I try to do better for my kids.
Do you think there's certain people in our community that want their kids to be into that life, that promote them, educate them into being, you know, into the street, into the criminal activity, into hustling? And have you ever came across any people like that in our community that they teach their kids or inherit, you know, that whole street life, you know, maybe put their kids to hustle for them or whatever?
Some people like that, you know what I'm saying? Like my cousin here, like he got into that because of that.
And I did it with my dad.
Exactly, you know what I mean? Some people, that's how it is. That's the only way they know. You know what I'm saying? Some people want their kids to do better, you know what I mean? But
so do you consider that keeping it real?
Yeah. Well, yeah, of course. They learn, even if you didn't want them to do it. They see that's what you were doing. So it's hard sometimes for you to try to tell them to do something different, but that you're doing the same, you're doing, but, you know what I'm saying, you're doing that. So I don't want my kid to hustle, but yeah, I'm the one hustling and he sees me hustling. So he's gonna look and see, he's gonna look and see everybody else. And so it's on you as a parent to try to steer them in a different way.
Definitely.
That's all that is, man.
So is there anything that you would like to like a message to put out there to these kids hanging on the benches?
Man, do something else with yourself, man. You ain't nothing gonna come out of here. You're just gonna be another statistic in the hood, you know what I mean? Either getting shot or drugs. Ain't nothing out of here. It's not like living in the projects is a bad thing, but if you could better yourself, then do that. Try to do that. That's what you gotta instill in your kid. That's all.
Definitely. Thank you, homie.
My mistakes. You see me going in and out? You had to sit there and invite me.
I wasn't
like,
going in. I've been just to the bookers and I couldn't take it.
No, I remember you using Sparkle.
I don't need the whole.
Remember they taking the Sparkle?
Experience.
Yeah, experience.
Bookers.
Now for a game or some shit.
Nah, fucking stupid shit. You know, I'm buying weed and fighting, you know what I'm saying? Having ball fights. I ain't never.
I locked up over a game. I remember a long time ago when we were little.
I ain't never.
In Malik.
Nowhere but the bookings. I ain't gonna pass the bookings.
I went past the bookings.
All right, thank you. Thank you, my brother, for your words.